welcome you to Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium on a cloudy Wednesday afternoon in historic Dahlonega, Georgia. 17 days and 7 games later, the number 2 team in the nation returns home to the Hill for a midweek doubleheader against one of the best programs in Division II softball. It's game 1 between the Alabama Huntsville Chargers and the North Georgia Nighthawks on the Nighthawk Sports Network. Glad to have you all with us today, alongside Bailey Vessel and the rest of the NSN team. Robert DiClemente on hand for you this afternoon. It's been a while since we've seen the Nighthawks have some home cooking. They return to Dahlonega, coming off their longest road stretch of the season. 7 straight games on the road after dropping the first matchup. The Nighthawks never looked back after that, winning the next 6, with 3 of those games ending in less than 7 innings. And Bailey, North Georgia looked great during that road trip, picking up some great non-conference wins. But perhaps the biggest win for them came at the end of that road trip in a PVC series against that number 2 team in the conference, Columbus State.
Yeah, that's a huge win for them. They're coming off a run-roll win and a series sweep against the number 2 team in the conference. And I know that gives them a huge momentum boost, and it's got to make them feel good. That's been a little bit of a rivalry so far in the past 2 seasons. Played them 7 times last year, so probably see them again, but just know that we've got their number this year, and hopefully we can keep that going.
Absolutely. Imagine, like you said, it won't be the last time that we see North Georgia and Columbus State face each other. And the Chargers, they come to the Gold City with an impressive 29-11 record, winning 11 of their last 13 and post arguably the biggest test for the number 2 team in the country in the regular season thus far. So it looks like we're going to have a great couple of games in store for you today. Again, glad to have you all with us this afternoon. Let's take a look at the starting lineup. First for Alabama Huntsville, that was just Lauren Hayes, who was walked by Kristen Davis in the circle. And following Hayes in the lineup, it's Sadie Thompson, Alexa Doffhit, Kaylee Vaught, Jada Henderson, Maddie Carton, Jessica Eddy, Kylie Smith, and Caitlin Bryson. We have a phenomenal crowd on hand for you this afternoon here at the Hill. Got the Cottrell first graders in attendance this afternoon. A bunt here as Mixon throws to second. Not on time, and so 2 early runners are going to be on base here for Alabama Huntsville after that bunt from Sadie Thompson. Let's take a look at who's in the outfield this afternoon for North Georgia. From first to third base, it's Marysil Grumby at first, Ward at second, and then Gracie Mixon holding it down at third. Riley Moody over there in shortstop. And the designated hitter for North Georgia today is going to be Grayson Perry. Behind the plate is, of course, the senior Georgia Blair. Then from left to right field, it's Sydney Blair. Then in center field, Mallory Parker. And holding it down in right is Mariah Wicker. Now up to bat is Alexa Doffhit. Runners on for Alabama Huntsville early. Doffhit, a sophomore out of Madison, Alabama.
I think the key for the Chargers is to put runners on base like they've done so far. Put the pressure on the defense. A lot of teams don't get a lot of runners on against the Nighthawks and this incredible pitching staff, so they're doing a great job already so far this first inning.
Grumby on her knees makes the throw to first. Ward shifted over, and the Nighthawks get a first out here in the top of the first. That advances runners. Like Bailey said, this is what Alabama Huntsville has to do in this one. Get runs on the board early. And we know that they're capable of it. This is one of the most high-powered offenses in the nation, right up there with North Georgia. And that's going to bring up Kaylee Vaught. Bought a graduate student out of Langston, Alabama. Graduated from Pisgah High School. She's gonna take ball 2 from Kristen Davis, getting the start in the circle for North Georgia today. And you can look on the screen there, Davis one of the best pitchers in not only the Peach Bowl Conference, but the entire nation. With all the innings that she's pitched, she's posted a phenomenal ERA, second in the Peach Bowl Conference. Posing batting average of 200 this year, also second best in the PBC. That duo of Kristen Davis and Tybee Denton, one of the best that you'll see in the nation.
I think when you got two pitchers that are that dynamic, just makes your life so much easier. I know Coach Davenport is going to miss these two seniors when they're gone. And they've just been so impactful to UNG and have been a big part of the success here these past few years.
3-1 outside for ball four. And so early in this matchup between North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville, bases are loaded, one out up on the board, which brings Jada Henderson up to bat. Henderson, a junior out of Hartselle, Alabama at Hartselle High School. And I'm trying to get out of a pinch here as Davis delivers a strike. Goes up 0-1 on Henderson. Bailey, you're absolutely right. Having Davis and Denon on your squad, you know, two pitchers who are, you know, some of the best that you'll see, two of the best to ever come through this North Georgia program. It's been great seeing them develop over the past handful of years, and North Georgia bringing their entire bullpen from that 2023 national championship run intact into this season, and it's been one of their biggest factors so far this season to their success. The 0-2, a swing and a miss as Davis deals her first strikeout of the afternoon. Brings us to two outs, and that's going to bring number 12, Maddie Carton, up to bat. Cartron, a senior out of Hazel Green, Alabama. Batting 369 this season. Her 104th at-bat. She's got 38 hits and 33 RBIs this season. Also seven home runs here in 2024. Mike Davis is going to deliver ball two. It'll be great to see if North Georgia is able to get out of this one in a pinch. Bases loaded. Looking for a routine play here. The 2-0 pitch. Right down the middle from Davis. Counts now 2-1. Davis gets the signal. The 2-1 pitch. Another one right down the middle from Davis. And just like that, she's even the count at 2-2. Pitch. This is going to be grounded to Mixon. Mixon gathers, throws to first on time for out number three. And so with the bases loaded, North Georgia keeps the Chargers off the board. And we're headed to the home half of the frame where Katie Ward is going to get things going for North Georgia when we come back right here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Softball would like to thank one of their season sponsors, JSR Heating and Cooling, a family-owned and operated HVAC company specializing in heating, cooling, and air purification of residential and commercial businesses. JSR Heating and Cooling, a proud sponsor of Nighthawk Softball. So the bases loaded in that top half of the first inning. North Georgia able to get out of it cleanly as they look to take the first lead here in game one of this doubleheader for you on the Nighthawk Sports Network again. Glad to have you all with us this afternoon. Like we mentioned, Katie Ward is going to lead things off here for North Georgia, top of the batting order for the Nighthawks. And the first pitch from Thompson this afternoon is going to be a ball. Let's take a look at the rest of the batting order for North Georgia. Following Ward, it's going to be Sydney Blair, then Georgia Blair. So we got back-to-back Blairs in the lineup, followed by Parker, Grayson Perry, Mariah Wicker, Marysil Brumby, Gracie Mixon, and Riley Moody. The junior shortstop is going to round out this batting order for North Georgia this afternoon. Getting the start in the circle is Josie Thompson for Alabama Huntsville. Delivers a strike, her first of the afternoon, to make it a 2-1 count for 2-1 Katie Ward. Thompson, a senior out of Bridgeport, Alabama. Delivers the 2-1. Ward fouls this one out of play. Pushes the count to 2-2. Thompson this season has posted a 2.91 ERA. This is her 20th appearance this season for the Chargers. And in those 20 appearances, she's pitched a little over 74 innings, allowing 84 hits while striking out 66 batters and walking 15 of them. Pretty great ratio there as Ward hits this one into right and gets things going here for North Georgia. The first hit of the afternoon belongs to the leadoff batter, Katie Ward.
I think that's what the Nighthawks need. With Joy Lester going down, going to be out for the season, I think Katie Ward's going to be in a big position. Joy Lester would reach base so often for the Nighthawks, and she's not going to be able to feel the shoes of Joy Lester necessarily, but just getting on base and just putting things in motion for the Nighthawks to get them rolling.
Absolutely, and for those of you that don't know, North Georgia's unfortunately going to be without Joy Lester, the star left fielder, for the rest of this season after going down with an ACL tear about a month ago, putting her out for the remainder of the season. That's left Coach Davenport with some decisions to make, because Lester was their leadoff hitter, like Bailey said, at the top of that batting order and a staple in left field. And it's taken the Nighthawks some time to adjust to some new lineups. We've seen Mariah Wicker in the leadoff spot a handful of times at the end of North Georgia's road trip. It was Katie Ward, who is at the top of the batting order for the Nighthawks. And Sydney Blair, who's up to bat right now, has taken over in left field for Lester. She's made a big jump this season with more playing time. And so the Nighthawks are adjusting on the fly here, and it seems to be working as they haven't really missed a beat as Blair fouls this one out of play. Count's going to be 0-2. Sydney Blair, a sophomore out of Peachtree City, Georgia. Some increased playing time this season. So after Lester went down, as she fouls another one out of play, battling here. Count still 0-2 against Thompson. Blair batting .338 this season. This is her 72nd at bat. Has 24 hits and 4 RBIs this season. Takes strike 3 from Thompson. Blair still out there. She's trying to plead her case here with the home plate ump, and now Coach Davenport's going to try to do the same. Maybe there's a debate between the first base ump and the home plate ump as to whether that was going to be an out. See if she checked her swing. And that is going to bring out number one up on the board.
Look like for Sydney Blair, she's just trying to run through the plate and just kind of hold her swing. But the umpire at home plate said that she went. And the Davenport and Katie Ward, Sydney Blair, they're all arguing that she held her swing back, and that's how she runs through.
It looks like the umps are going to meet on that right field line to talk things over here. That would mean no outs, and Georgia Blair, the team's leader in RBIs, who's on the docket to bat next. And it looks like North Georgia is not going to win this argument here, unfortunately, as Sydney Blair heads back to the dugout and Georgia Blair steps into the batter's box. Blair, a senior out of Douglasville, Georgia, and Alexander High School. One of the many vets on this North Georgia roster, and whether she's doing some damage behind the plate or up to bat, she's one of the most lethal players on this North Georgia roster. Second on the team in batting average, 381 this season. That's also a top 10 number in the Peach Belt Conference. Takes a strike to make it an 0-1 count. Blair has seen the plate most out of any Nighthawk this season. This is her 119th at bat. The 0-2 count, Blair fouls this one, so we're going to stay put at an 0-2 count. Blair has 45 hits this season, also leads the Nighthawks. She leads the Nighthawks in hits, RBIs, and home runs with 9 bombs on the season. And the 1-2, another foul ball. This one skies over the stands here at the hill, so we're going to stay at a 1-2 count. As Thompson looks for her signal 1-2 pitch. And Ward's going to make a break for it to second, and she's going to slide in safely. Another stolen base for North Georgia, their first of the game, and that's been one of the biggest reasons for their success this season. A lot of speedsters on this North Georgia squad, puts runners in scoring position, and now things are a bit easier for Georgia Blair. If she's able to get something down and right, should score Katie Ward from second. 2-2, another foul ball. This one hits the net. And if we take a look at the field for Alabama Huntsville, from first to third base, it's Cartran, Hayes, and then over there at third, Doffitt. As Blair grounds this one to the third baseman, throw to first, gets there on time for out number two. And then from left to right field, it's Vaught, Thompson, and Bryson. And then Smith over there in shortstop. Behind the plate for Alabama Huntsville is Eddie. And then, like we said, getting a start in the circle, Josie Thompson. That brings another North Georgia senior up to bat, Mallory Parker. Takes a strike from Thompson, 4-0-1 count. Parker, a senior out of Kennesaw, Georgia, and Kennesaw Mountain High School. Takes the 0-1. Makes the count 1-1. Parker's had a nice bounce back year after missing almost all of last season due to an injury. Batting 342 on the season, has started every game she's appeared in for North Georgia. 38 hits and 24 RBIs, along with 4 home runs this year. One of those was an inside the park home run about a month ago here at the Hill. Parker shows bunt, pulls it back, 1-2. Outside. So we got a 2-2 count for number two. And Bailey, like we mentioned, this North Georgia roster is littered with seniors, Parker being one of them, and this is one of the most veteran teams that you'll see in the nation.
Yeah, definitely a lot of seniors and fortunate strikes out there, but a very deep squad and a lot of experience for this team.
So a couple strikeouts from Thompson ends the inning, takes us to the top of the second. Still scoreless in this one between North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville. We will step aside for a short commercial break. You're watching North Georgia Softball on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
We have a long tradition of athletics at the University of North Georgia. For the past 50 years, our athletic programs have been making a difference for our university. And today, I'm really excited to talk about how we will take that to the next level. When you think about elite athletics, you think about elite performance. Mary Robb, tell me what that means to you.
So elite performance at the University of North Georgia is unique because we have a value proposition unlike anybody else in this country, where we're able to perform at the highest level because of our connections with our Corps of Cadets and our College of Health Sciences and Professions, coupled with our professionals from coaches, athletic trainers, support staff, and our Department of Athletics. But we're preparing our student athletes to battle on the field of competition, in the classroom, and in our community. We'll be elite in every.
Network here in the top of the second inning, where Jessica Eddy is going to lead things off here for the Chargers. Jessica Eddy, a senior out of Estill Springs, Tennessee, finds herself in a 1-1 count against Kristen Davis. The 1-1, this one's hit right to Brumby, doesn't even have to move her feet there on the play. Gives us our first out in the top of the second. So that brings up number 8, Kylie Smith, a freshman out of Wetumpka, Alabama, and Macon East Academy. Takes ball 1 from Kristen Davis. Smith batting 145 on the season. This is her 84th at-bat. Has 12 hits on the season, 12 runs scored as well. 11 RBIs and 2 homers for the freshman. And the 1-1 pitch, a swing and a miss, is going to put Kristen Davis up 1-2. And last season, when these two squads faced off, it was on the road, and it was a top 5 matchup. North Georgia was ranked number 1 in the country at the time. Alabama Huntsville ranked number 5 as Davis picks up another strikeout for her own this afternoon. North Georgia was able to come away with the doubleheader sweep last season over the Chargers. And still, even though Alabama Huntsville isn't ranked as of right now, you know, they've got the makeups of a top 25 team.
Yeah, this is still a really good Alabama Huntsville team. Definitely not as good as last season, but they're 29-11. Going to be a tough matchup in this doubleheader for the Nighthawks.
So that brings the bottom of the batting order up to bat. Caitlin Bryson, senior out of Hartsell, Alabama. This is also a very veteran squad for Alabama Huntsville as well. A lot of seniors on this roster. I believe that the only freshman in the starting lineup is Smith.
The thing about the break for the Nighthawks, there's a lot of seniors in the starting lineup, but there's also a lot of freshmen as well, a lot of young players, so a good balanced lineup for the Nighthawks. They're definitely going to miss the senior team and the senior class.
No doubt about it. Every player up and down this North Georgia roster is as good as they come, including, like I said, we have a couple of freshmen incoming this season who have played great in the minutes that they've been able to play this year. Also a couple of breakout sophomores, as well as Davis deals another strikeout. Her third of the afternoon ends this top half of the second inning. Brings us to the bottom of the second. North Georgia's up to bat when we come back here on the Nighthawk Sports Network. River City Bank is today's second inning sponsor, and they're here to make banking easy and convenient, serving Rome, Blairsville, and Dawsonville. When it comes to meeting your financial needs, they won't settle for anything less than exceptional. To learn more, visit rivercity.bank. Grayson Perry is going to lead things off here for North Georgia in the bottom of the second. Perry, a junior out of Monroe, Georgia, in Walnut Grove High School, has also seen some increased playing time this season, and that's absolutely paid off. Her numbers are up across the board this season. She's third on the team in batting average, .357 on the season, has 25 hits, 17 RBIs, 4 home runs, and a .600 slugging percentage for the junior.
Yeah, Perry's been here for 3 years and hasn't played very much, but like you mentioned, just been a great asset in her third year, just kind of come on in a storm and couple home runs. Been a very good addition to this lineup. Glad to see her finally get some meaningful minutes.
Finds herself up 2-1 against Thompson. And the 2-1 pitch, this is hit right to first, and the easy out will be made as Catron is able to get her foot on the bag. That's going to bring up number 11, Mariah Wicker, next up in the batting order. Mariah, a senior out of Buford, Georgia, another veteran on this North Georgia squad, batting .343 this season. This is her 106th appearance at the plate. She has 36 hits this season, 23 RBIs, and 4 homers. The 0-1 pitch from Thompson, a big swing there from Mariah Wicker, but a miss is going to give us an 0-2 count up on the scoreboard. And the 0-2 pitch to Wicker, this is going to be left outside for ball one. Thompson has her eye on her wrist. 1-2 pitch upstairs for ball two. When you look at the numbers for North Georgia as a team, batting-wise, they have a .349 batting average, which leads the conference and is 11th highest nationally. 395 hits, again, atop the conference, and that's 6th most nationally. As Wicker strikes out here, and a couple of big strikeouts early in this game for Thompson. As, like Davis, she's been dealing to start this game out with two outs, brings Brumby up to bat. This North Georgia squad also averaging over 7 runs scored per game, second in the league and 15th in the country, as Brumby swings and misses on this one. That's a 314 total runs scored. That's the 6th most out of any team in Division II softball. The 0-1 pitch to Brumby is left outside for a ball. Brumby also seeing some increased playing time as of recent with Sophie Mooney inactive for today. She did not play in that final game against Columbus State either. The 1-1 is going to be low for ball two.
And Brumby is one of those players that's kind of broken out this season. Got her first home run against Columbus State last weekend. Also got a grand slam, so she's on fire right now. And I know Coach Davenport wants Sophie Mooney back, but Brumby has done a nice job stepping up.
Brumby fouls this one out of play and over the stands here at the Hill. Yeah, Brumby has been huge for the Nighthawks over these last handful of days. Like you said, had her first collegiate home run against Columbus State, followed that up with the grand slam, and that just goes to show you the depth of this North Georgia squad to have somebody like Brumby on this roster who did play a ton last season. He's playing some huge minutes for the Nighthawks this year, and it has absolutely paid off. She pops out here into foul territory. Alabama Huntsville makes the play, takes us to the third. Still scoreless in this one between North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Awesome if you could buy your next vehicle without going to the dealership. Now you can with Beaver Direct. It's fast and really simple. Log into BeaverToyotaCumming.com, click on Beaver Direct, quietly shop from hundreds of vehicles, obtain a credit approval and trade appraisal in minutes.
Northeast Georgia Health System is a proud supporter of North Georgia Nighthawk Athletics.
The road to national championships runs through NCAA.com. And whether you follow one college team or all of them, it's never been easier to get the content you want with NCAA.com, the home of college sports.
Bryant Properties is a commercial real estate brokerage firm serving Northeast Georgia and presenting today's third inning. Located in nearby Cumming, Georgia, Bryant Properties specializes in commercial real estate along the Georgia 400 corridor. For more information on Bryant Properties, visit bryantproperties.net. So Alabama Huntsville returns to the top of their batting order with Hayes. Chargers still looking for their first hit this afternoon. Kristen Davis may have other plans, though. Delivers a strike to even the count at 1-1. Davis gets the signal. 1-1 pitch. Two count. We mentioned how lethal this North Georgia batting is. Chargers right up there with them, batting 347 as a team this season, 12th best in the nation, just one spot behind North Georgia. As this is going to go down as strike three, another swing and a miss there from Hayes gives us our first out in this top of the third. Chargers also have 373 total hits this season, 13th best nationally. And 301 runs scored, eighth most nationally. All this to go along with a top 10 scoring offense and on-base percentage in the country. Alabama, Huntsville, and North Georgia, they feature two of the most high-powered offenses that you'll see in Division II softball.
It's crazy with you saying that. So far we have one hit between both squads, so expecting a high-scoring game, but haven't got that so far. Both pitchers have done well to keep them off the scoreboard.
And not only are these, North Georgia bats and Alabama Huntsville bats, some of the best that you'll see, but these two bullpens also as good as they come. North Georgia's bullpen, one of the best in the Peach Belt Conference this season, posting a 1.87 ERA, holding opponents to a 181 batting average so far this season. As Davis delivers ball two. Like we mentioned earlier, keeping their entire bullpen intact from that 2023 national championship.
The 2-1, this is going to be popped out into right center field. Parker and Wicker were there, and Parker ends up coming up with the catch and puts out number two up on the board.
That was a nice play by Mallory Parker. Had to track that ball really far. Wasn't sure which one was going to catch it, but they both did a nice job to talk, and Parker does a nice job to call Wicker off, who was also right there.
So that's going to bring the center fielder Thompson back up to bat. Or excuse me, Duffett up to bat. Thompson just flew out on that last at-bat. Duffett grounded out. Last time she was up to bat, finds herself down 1-0 against Davis. Takes a strike inside the zone from the senior Kristen Davis. 1-1 count. Davis gets the signal, 1-1 pitch, low for ball two. We're mentioning North Georgia's pitching staff holding opponents to a 181 batting average, leading them to 12 shutouts, 261 strikeouts coming into this matchup. Davis has already added to that, while only allowing 176 hits this season, as this is going to be popped up into shallow center field at second. Moody makes the routine play, takes us to the bottom half of this third inning. Still scoreless in this one. We'll see if the Nighthawks are able to break through first when we come back right here on the Nighthawk Sports Network. Back with you here on the Nighthawk Sports Network on this cloudy Wednesday afternoon in Dahlonega. A bit misty outside, not seeing the rain like we did yesterday, though, here in the Gold City. So in this bottom half of the third inning, Gracie Mixon is going to lead things off here for North Georgia. Mixon takes a strike for an 0-1 count. Gracie Mixon, a senior out of Canton, Georgia, and Cherokee High School. Mixon takes ball one. And Mixon, she's one of the most consistent players that you'll find on this North Georgia roster, batting 301 this season, has 28 hits and 28 RBIs. Two home runs on the season also for the senior Mixon. 1-1 is inside. Now Mixon finds herself down 1-2 against Thompson, who's pitched a nice game so far here for North Georgia. Only one hit, three strikeouts, hasn't walked a batter yet. 1-2 to Mixon, just outside for ball two, evens the count up. The double P signs here from the home plate ump. And the 2-2 as Mixon fouls this one out of play. And just like North Georgia, the Chargers, they have a star-studded bullpen themselves, with their pitchers holding opponents to a 262 batting average while posting a 3.46 ERA while averaging 7.5 strikeouts per 7 innings, which is the 8th most nationally. This is grounded right back to the pitcher, Thompson, and the toss to first, well on time for out number one. That brings up the bottom of the batting order here, the shortstop, Riley Moody, junior out of Douglasville, Georgia. one of the few transfers on this North Georgia roster, coming over from Wallace State. She's been filling in at shortstop this season after Maddie Perry graduated last season, held that position down for a long time. But Bailey, it's been an even swap here as Riley Moody, she's looked great at shortstop this season so far for North Georgia.
Yeah, she has. And I think Coach Davenport, he tried a couple different shortstops out there to start the season and then decided on Riley Moody, who kind of established herself ahead of the pack. And I think she's filled in nicely and done a nice job over there, short defensively and also behind the plate.
No doubt about it. A stud at short and a stud up to bat. Moody batting .333 on the season. Just 28 hits, 20 RBIs, and 4 home runs as well. A .595 slugging percentage for Riley Moody as well. Finds herself at a 1-2 count. Shows bunt against Thompson. Pulls it back. Takes ball 2 upstairs. Still no runners on for North Georgia. Another 2-2 count. And the 2-2 inside the zone for strike 3. And we mentioned the high strikeout rate per 7 innings for Alabama Huntsville. Thompson shown exactly why there. Picks up another strikeout. Her 4th of the afternoon.
Yeah, and Thompson has looked dominant so far the first time through this lineup. Katie Ward, leadoff, got a little bloop hit, but other than that, the Hawks have been either struck out or just hit some dinkers to the infield, so she's dominated so far first time through the lineup.
It's been a lot of routine plays. Neither team has been able to break through here quite yet. The 1-0 pitch to Ward. Inside the zone, fastball there is going to make it a 1-1 count for Katie Ward. North Georgia, they have fared well in their midweek doubleheaders this season. They're 6-0 in midweek out-of-conference doubleheaders at home. 4 of those games ended in run rule wins for the Nighthawks. It's a 1-2 count for Katie Ward. 2 outs up on the board. Nobody on for North Georgia. They're the only player with a hit this afternoon. It's another foul ball. This one's going to drop in foul territory over there in right field. The count's going to stay right where it is at 1-2. Got Sydney Blair on deck for North Georgia. Ward takes the 1-2, and she takes a pitch to the helmet there from Thompson. And Coach Davenport is going to come out to first base to check on Katie Ward. Never want to take a pitch like that. Didn't look intentional, though, from Thompson. Just unfortunate there as Ward takes off her helmet and trainers are coming out to check on her. And, you know, we saw a couple of days ago for North Georgia baseball, Jorge Arisparo took a pitch to the helmet. That one clipped him on the face, actually, and a broken nose. And luckily Ward, you know, takes this one to the side of the helmet. Still, you never want to see a pitch go to the helmet or any sort of head injuries in sports.
Yeah, definitely can be scary. Definitely a scary moment when Jorge Risper got hit. Hopefully Katie Ward's going to be fine. Looked like it just hit her in the helmet, but maybe a player that's dealt with concussions before, so just going to check her out, make sure that she's okay. Always a scary moment when anybody gets hit in the head.
Absolutely. Like we said, definitely did not look intentional from Thompson. Just unfortunate that that's the way that that played out. Ward puts her helmet back on. Looks to be all right. She's nodding her head at Davo, so she's going to stay at first. And that brings the sophomore, Sydney Blair, back up to bat. We mentioned earlier, Sydney Blair taking over in left field for Jolie Lester, and Now, how about Sydney Blair? She stepped up big time for North Georgia this season. Taking over in left field. Has been holding it down really well out there. And on the road against Lee, she had one of the best games of her career, going a perfect 4-for-4 at the plate. She's another example of a player like Katie Ward, who's taken a leap in year two and is one of the big reasons why North Georgia has been holding steady since Lester went down.
Yeah, I think it's valuable for Sydney Blair. She got a lot of action in her freshman year with Mallory Parker going down so early. She was a big part of that national championship team, came in and filled the shoes of Parker. And this year, with Parker coming back, she finds herself in a limited role to start the season. But then with Lester going down, she finds herself back in a big, prominent role, and she's done nicely so far.
Blair pops this one up, and that's going to be caught in foul territory by the catcher, Eddie, which brings an end to this third inning and takes us to the fourth, still scoreless between North Georgia, the number two ranked team in the nation, and Alabama Huntsville here on the Nighthawk Sports Network. We will step aside and be back soon. Fourth inning today is brought to you by Raymond Carolina Handling, a proud supporter of North Georgia Softball, a premier material handling solutions provider. Carolina Handling is the exclusive Raymond Solutions and Support Center in the Southeast and a leader in integrated automation systems that help customers move more, faster, and at less cost. Let us help you discover the smartest way to move your business forward. So as we head to the top of the fourth, still scoreless in this one between the number two ranked team in the nation, North Georgia, and Alabama Huntsville. Both of these teams trying to find some life here at the plate. And Vaught is going to lead things off here for the Chargers to start this fourth inning. Vaught was walked on her last at-bat, her first of the afternoon, by Kristen Davis. Just one of two batters that's been walked by the star senior, Davis. Davis delivers strike two, quickly up against Vaught. Davis gets her signal. And the 1-2 just outside for ball two. Vaught showing bunt, pulls it back, hits this one right back to Davis, who's going to make the easy throw to Brumby at first. Gives us our first out here in the top of the fourth. And we mentioned the dominance of this North Georgia pitching staff earlier in the game, and they have 261 strikeouts coming into this afternoon, only allowing 176 hits. And just to show you the absurdity of that last stat, the team that trails North Georgia with the second least amount of hits in the Peach Bowl Conference allowed is USC Aiken with 267, which is still great. But the Nighthawks have allowed almost 100 less hits than the second best pitching staff in the conference.
Yeah, that's an insane stat. And Davis and Denton have done a fantastic job this season. Definitely expect both of them to be on the Peach Belt first team, all conference team, and excited to see how far they can take this team.
No doubt about it. Expect to see Denton start game two here for North Georgia. That's been the typical 1-2 punch for Coach Davo. Start in a doubleheader, start Davis in game one and then Denton in game two. So And we got a 1-2 count for Jada Henderson, was struck out by Davis last time she was up to bat. Slams one into left, and that's going to get over the head of Sydney Blair. And Blair's going to throw to second for the first hit of the afternoon. It goes to Jada Henderson, a double here, puts a runner on second with Cartron up to bat yet again here for Alabama Huntsville.
Henderson hit that ball hard. It didn't look like Sydney Blair played that ball great, though. It looked like she kind of ran in a few steps in that ball. She got burnt on that ball. But nice hit by Henderson to hit it hard and put it in play.
A pitch in the ground from Davis is going to put a runner in scoring position for Alabama Huntsville. The first time that they've had a runner on third since that top of the first. Dangerous territory here for North Georgia. Runner in scoring position, 1-0 count two for Cartron.
And the way that this game is going, it feels like one or two runs may be all that a team needs to win. So this is definitely dangerous territory, like you said, for the Nighthawks.
Like we said, even though these are two of the most high-powered offenses in the country as far as batting average goes, like we said, these two pitching staffs, phenomenal as well. The 2-0 pitch from Davis. It's going to be inside the zone, down the middle for strike one. Yeah, like Bailey mentioned, wouldn't be surprised to see Davis and Denton on that PBC all-conference team as Davis delivers the 2-1 upstairs for 2-2. I think for Tybee Denton, also pitcher of the year, is absolutely in the cards as well.
Yeah, unless she just has a ultimate collapse here at the end of the season, I think that's pretty much locked up in the bag for her with every single category, almost leading in the Peach Belt. She's been fantastic this season.
Count runs full for the Chargers and Henderson, the designated hitter. For Cartron. The first baseman swings and misses, and Davis picks up yet another strikeout, her fifth this afternoon. These pitchers have been dealing so far in this game. Still scoreless, two outs. He's going to bring Eddie back up to bat. Davis delivers ball one upstairs. Chargers coming over from a stacked Gulf South Conference that features great teams like themselves, West Florida, and two top 25 teams in Auburn, Montgomery, and Mississippi College. The 1-0 pitch to Eddie inside for strike one, and just to show you how talented the players are in that Gulf South Conference, 17 players in the conference are batting 400 or higher with at least 80 at-bats. And the 1-1 pitch, a swing and a miss, is going to make it a 1-2 count. If you take Doffitt's, Henderson's, and Hayes' batting averages this season and put them in the Peach Bowl Conference, Doffitt's would be the best, and Henderson and Hayes would rank top five. In their own conference, they rank top 10, but it's still amazing to see that there are three players batting better than 460, which is just an insanely high batting average.
And that may contribute to their record a little bit with 11 losses. If they're that dynamic as of a conference, then it's going to be tough to get wins. The team is 9-8 on the road. They've struggled a little bit. 11-0 at home, but you got to go to those places. Sometimes it's hard to beat those teams that have that good of players.
Another strikeout for Davis. Number six this afternoon keeps the Chargers scoreless as we're headed to the bottom of the fourth. We'll see if North Georgia can break through first when we come back on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
My name is Lana Titterina, and UNG is where I lead. I chose UNG because of the tennis program and how much the tennis program has achieved in the past, and I wanted to be a part of building a good team. But also the campus is very beautiful, their location. It has the new business building that I really like. And when I did my research, I really liked Dahlonega in Georgia. So one of the biggest challenges that I faced was coming here and not knowing anyone. I didn't know how the culture was and how to really approach people. And being new and not knowing anyone can be tough in the beginning. So you have to really put yourself out there and make connections, talk to people. So that's where I feel like I've grown a lot and I've gotten to know a lot of people here, and that has helped my experience. My advice for international students would be just go for it. It may be tough in the beginning, but it's all going to be worth it at the end. You're going to meet amazing people. It's really fun, and you get a very good degree.
Back with you here on the Nighthawk Sports Network in the bottom of the fourth inning in this game one of our doubleheader between the number two team in the nation, North Georgia, and Alabama Huntsville on the Nighthawk Sports Network. If you're just now joining us, still scoreless in this one through the first 3.5 innings of play. Nighthawks looking to break through first here at Haynes and Carolyn Hill as Georgia Blair is leading things off here for North Georgia in the bottom of the fourth. Finds herself in a 1-1 count against Thompson. Georgia Blair in the middle of a 6-game hitting streak. She had 2 home runs this past weekend, putting her in the lead for most home runs on the team this year with 9. She fouls another ball out of play. Also leads the team with 37 RBIs as well. Blair now in a 1-2 count against Thompson. Already has 4 strikeouts this afternoon, delivers the 1-2. This one's going to be low for ball 2. Got a cool and cloudy day here in Dahlonega. A bit windy outside, not too bad though compared to yesterday. Had some downpour in Dahlonega yesterday for North Georgia baseball as Blair pops this one up into right center field, and that's going to be caught by the right fielder for out number 1, and that was Bryson making the play over there at the 210 marker. That's going to bring up Mallory Parker back up to bat for North Georgia. Looking to bounce back here at home after not securing a hit in any of the 3 games this past weekend. But odds are she's going to get a hit in this game. Parker has never in her career gone 4 straight games in a season without a hit. So the odds and the bat are definitely in her favor. Nixon shows bunt here as she typically does. Pulls it back. Fouls this one back towards the net. Quickly down 0-2 to Thompson. Thompson again looking at her right wrist, delivers the 0-2. Another foul ball from Mallory Parker. This one going over the dugout for Alabama Huntsville. Parker again shows bunt in an 0-2 count. One out, pulls it back. A swing and a miss here, and that's going to be another strikeout for Thompson, her 5th this afternoon. Nighthawks looking for their 2nd hit here in this game 1. We'll see if Grayson Perry, the designated hitter, can deliver for North Georgia here.
That came Katie Warren, the first at bat of the game, and she's been the only base runner so far. She got hit in her last at bat. But other than that, the Nighthawks have been held off the base pass, and Thompson is definitely keeping these hitters in check.
Yeah, the Nighthawks and the Chargers both been kept at bay in this one. Grayson Perry up at a 1-0 count. And the pitch outside for ball two. And after a handful of hitless games during that road stretch that North Georgia was just on, Grayson Perry, she had her best game of the season last time out against Columbus State. She was a perfect 3-for-3 at the plate, highlighted by a grand slam to help seal that win for North Georgia in that series finale. So the Chargers, after a quick discussion in the circle with their infield, going to resume play here. Still a 2-0 count for Perry. And the 2-0. This one gets past the catcher, Eddie. Count's going to be 3-0 for number 3, Perry. Wouldn't be surprised to see her not swing on this next pitch from Thompson. First 3-0 count that we've seen from Thompson this afternoon. And the pitch outside for ball four. And so Thompson walks her first batter of the afternoon. It's going to put Grayson Perry over there on first. And Coach Davenport is going to have a pinch hitter on one of his heavy hitters. Number 7, Madison Simmons, is going to step up to bat here for North Georgia. Simmons, a senior out of Suwanee, Georgia, batting .391 this season. This is just her 24th at-bat of the season. But those 23 at-bats, she's made the most of it. 9 hits and 11 RBIs and a home run to go along with that. And Coach Davenport wants to put one of the big bats out there here for North Georgia with a runner on as they look to take the first lead here in this game.
I like the change by Coach Davenport, too. Wicker's only got one at bat, but no one has done anything so far. Just change stuff up and see if something can get going with a runner on.
And the 1-0 outside now, 2-0 for Madison Simmons. And she was in action during that series against Columbus State, had 2 plate appearances, didn't have a hit. But also during that road trip, went 2-for-2 against Shorter in game 2. Also secured a hit against Lee University back on March 27th during that road trip. Simmons is going to take strike one from Thompson. So you got 2 big bats in Simmons and Brumby. Now who's on deck for North Georgia. The 2-1 pitch as Simmons grounds this one to the short, and the throw to first is on time, but off the bag was the first baseman, Cartron. Unable to make a play there for Alabama Huntsville. Puts 2 runners on for North Georgia, and Brumby back up to bat.
I love the effort there by Madison Simmons. Coming in as a pinch hitter and throwing her body on the line. Dives to first and did a little scorpion there, but is able to reach first safely and keep this inning going for the Hawks.
Yeah, great effort play there from Madison Simmons, and it's going to be Mariah Wicker who pinch runs on first for North Georgia, and it looks like Caroline Branch is going to pinch run on second for the Nighthawks. And so Grayson Perry will step off, and the sophomore out of Bogart, Georgia, Caroline Branch, will step on to second, puts a speedster in scoring position for Brumby. Like Bailey mentioned earlier, Brumby, before that series against Columbus State, didn't have a collegiate home run. In that series, hit one, not one, but 2 home runs in that as she pops this one out into right field, back at the wall. The Chargers make the play as Bryson comes up with the grab. Brumby almost had enough underneath that one. Couldn't make the play, though. Gives us out number 3 and brings us to the top of the 5th. Still scoreless in this one on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
I I need to try it first.
Number 32, Kyle Hornsby.
Inside the 30, touchdown. Michaela Burgess.
An incredible finish by Holmes.
The NCAA and its member schools offer nearly 500,000 college athletes a path to go pro in something other than sports. Learn more at NCAA.org.
Today's fifth inning is presented by Commercial Floor Resources. Commercial Floor Resources has over 40 years of experience implementing flooring installations and best practices and is a proud supporter of North Georgia softball. Commercial Floor Resources provides high-quality flooring solutions to commercial industries across the country. So as we head to the top of the fifth inning, still donuts up on the scoreboard for North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville. Smith is going to lead things off here for the Chargers in this top half of the fifth inning. Last time Smith was up to bat, she was struck out by Kristen Davis, one of her six strikeouts this afternoon. And this is shaping up to be a low-scoring affair in this one. Like we mentioned, the bats for these two teams, some of the best that you'll see in the nation, but the pitching that's been on display so far in this game has been pretty great between Davis and Thompson, as Davis is going to deliver ball one to Eddie. Or to Smith, excuse me. The 1-2 pitch coming up here from Kristen Davis. This is going to be popped up into right. Brumby can't make a play on it. This is going to soar over the Nighthawks' bullpen. So the count's going to stay right where it is at 1-2. As Davis gets her signal, the 1-2 pitch. This one's going to be popped up high into left field, but fouled. Count's going to stay put at 1-2. And the Chargers, they're no strangers to taking down ranked teams. They've already got two wins over ranked opponents this season in Mississippi College and Tampa. Both of those were top 10 wins for this Chargers squad. Another 1-2 pitch from Davis. This is going off of her glove, but no problem there for Kristen Davis as she's able to make the clean play to Brumby. Gives us our first out in the top of the fifth. Now the bottom of the batting order, back up to bat, Caitlin Bryson. Bryson's going to take ball one here from Kristen Davis. Bryson, a .257 batter this season. 18 hits, 18 runs, and 8 RBIs. Takes the 1-0 from Kristen Davis, and Davis paints the inside of the zone for strike one. And the 1-1 pitch from Davis. Another one inside the zone for 1-2. And there's many ways in which this Charger team can score. One of those ways coming by their home runs. They have 55 so far, which is just outside of the top 10 nationally. This is going right into the glove. A great sliding catch there from Katie Ward. Gives us our second out and another fantastic effort play there from North Georgia. So the Chargers return to the top of their batting order with Lauren Hayes. North Georgia's done a great job of keeping Hayes at bay in this one. Their leadoff batter She's also 16th in the country with a whopping 60 hits already this season. The 1-0 is going to be upstairs from Kristen Davis. Now a 2-0 count. Last season, Hayes was not only the best hitter on this Charger lineup, but in general, one of the best hitters in the country. She had 82 hits last season. Finds herself in a 2-1 count here with Davis. Davis gets the signal, 2-1. This is going to be fouled. So deuces are running wild. 2 balls, 2 strikes, and 2 outs up on the scoreboard. Chargers looking for their second hit this afternoon. And the 2-2 from Davis. This is going to be popped up right to Riley Moody at short. Makes the easy grab. Takes us to the bottom of the fifth. Nighthawks looking to break through first when we come back right here on the Nighthawk Sports Network. Welcome back, everybody, to the Nighthawk Sports Network here on a cloudy Wednesday afternoon in the Gold City. Head into the bottom of the fifth inning in this matchup between North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville. Game one of our doubleheader for you here on the Nighthawk Sports Network. Robert DiClemente alongside Bailey Vessel this afternoon. It's going to be Gracie Mixon. It's going to lead things off here for the Nighthawks in the bottom of the fifth. Nighthawks looking for their second hit this afternoon. The only hit coming from Katie Ward on the first at-bat for North Georgia in this game. Haven't found a hit since. Mixon is going to take a ball from Thompson. Goes up 2-0. Mixon grounded out last time she was up to bat. Looking for something different here. Leading off for the Nighthawks in this bottom half of the inning. 2-0 for Mixon. It's going to be upstairs.
Thompson's having a little bit of control issues here in this later half of the inning. He's a walk and hit by pitch, and 3-0 on Gracie Mixon. Nighthawks need base runners, and if that's how they can get on base, then they need to take advantage of that and be more selective at the plate.
Absolutely. They're starting to find some cracks here in Thompson's game as she delivers 4 straight balls to walk her second batter this afternoon. Mixon not having to do too much on that plate appearance. Brings up Riley Moody, and you know, North Georgia's going to have to take advantage of any opportunities that they can get, finding some holes in Thompson's game, who has been terrific to start this game out through the first handful of innings, but in the fourth and the fifth, she started to slip a bit here, like Bailey has said, as Moody shows bunt and fouls this one out of play. Nighthawks trying to take advantage here. Moody up to bat was struck out last time she was up to bat. Look for something different here. Rounds out the batting order for North Georgia. Takes the 0-1, a big swing there from Moody, but a miss is going to make it an 0-2 count.
I'm a little surprised that Coach Davenport didn't butt Moody there, the number 9 hole hitter. Katie Ward's been your most successful hitter today, and a little surprised to see him not get her to bunt to move Gracie Mixon into scoring position.
The 0-2, this one's fouled out of play, and definitely surprising to see there, especially with no outs here in this bottom of the fifth. Putting a runner in scoring position with your leadoff batter. Definitely be the move that you would think, but Riley Moody, she's been on a tear, currently on a 5-game hitting streak. 3 of those games have been multi-hit performances from her. Takes her first ball from Thompson. So it's now a 1-2 count. And the 1-2, a big swing there from Riley Moody, but Thompson wins that matchup. Another strikeout, her 6th this afternoon, and now Thompson and Davis both with 6 strikeouts here in game 1. Gives us our first out, and the leadoff batter, Katie Ward, stepping back into the batter's box. Like we mentioned earlier, Katie Ward has taken over as the leadoff batter for North Georgia. As of recently, she's been the leadoff batter since North Georgia took on Columbus State this past weekend. As Coach Davenport's been experimenting with his leadoff batters since Jolie Lester went down, like we mentioned earlier, saw Mariah Wicker lead off this batting order for a handful of games. And as of recent, it's been the sophomore Katie Ward who's been etched into the top of this batting order for Coach Davo. And the 0-2 is going to be upstairs to Katie Ward. And the reason why we've seen her lead off for the Nighthawks here is because of the big jump that she's made from year 1 to year 2. Last season, Ward only played in 17 games and had 19 at-bats with 5 hits. But here in 2024, she's played much more as she fouls this one right into the glove of number 33, Doffitt. Pops it up for out number 2. But in 2024, Katie Ward, she started 32 games with 92 at-bats coming into this afternoon, 33 hits and 7 home runs, all while having the 4th best batting average on this team. Brings Sydney Blair back up to bat. Finds herself in a quick 0-1 count against Thompson. Blair has struck out and a fly out on her 2 plate appearances today. And the 0-1, this is going to be slammed into right field, but popped up right into the glove of Bryson. A couple of routine plays here for the Chargers takes us to the 6. It's getting late here in this game 1, still scoreless between the Nighthawks and the Chargers. We'll step aside for a short commercial break and be back on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
My wife's family is full of medical professionals, including lots of nurses. The more they talk to me about nursing, the more I realize there are so many different opportunities within the field of nursing. You can constantly continue growing, continue learning, which was something that really drew me to it. I was really attracted to the accelerated program at UNG for a couple reasons. One, I heard that UNG, like everything I've heard about UNG's nursing program is incredible. I have a couple friends who have been through it in recent years and had just spoke very highly of it. Just everything I've seen online, spoken about it, it's just a very reputable program. So UNG was already a pretty clear choice for me. And then seeing the opportunity to do an accelerated program, it was kind of a no-brainer. Honestly, I get to graduate earlier, and one of the things that appealed to me the most, actually, was that most of our clinical rotations are at Northeast Georgia Medical Center. I am really thankful for the faculty that are specifically dedicated to the ABSN program here. This faculty, they really want to see us succeed in this program and be the best nurses we can possibly be.
back with you here on the Nighthawk Sports Network in the top of the sixth inning. That's brought to you by Bees Bales. Today's sixth inning sponsor, Bees Bales, a leader in agricultural production in Cherokee County. So leading things off here for the Chargers in the top of the sixth inning is going to be number 23, the center fielder, Sadie Thompson. Reached base on a fielder's choice. Last time she was up to bat, finds herself down quickly, 0-2 against Kristen Davis. Davis has been sensational in the circle for North Georgia in this one, only allowing one hit, has six strikeouts, has walked two batters. Almost identical numbers to Thompson, except Thompson has allowed just one more hit for North Georgia. So the count's still 0-2 for Thompson. And a staple for the Chargers this season has been their sack bunts, putting someone on second or in third in a position to score. And a lot of that can be traced back to Sadie Thompson, who leads the nation in sack bunts per game. Takes the 0-2, pops this one up to Brumby, only has to move back about four or five steps to make the easy grab for out number one.
We have not had too many balls hit into the outfield so far. A lot of the hits or balls have been put in play by both teams have been little dinks to the infield, and I think we've only had a handful of balls hit into the outfield.
Yeah, just a couple of hits going towards Mariah Wicker or Sydney Blair's way. Mallory Parker not having to do too much out there in center field as of right now. Yeah, it's been just a lot of pop flies to Brumby or Moody. This is going to be a hit hard but fouled out of play by Dothit. Dothit ranking top 15 in the nation in total RBIs this season. She's just one shy of hitting the 50 mark this year. And an RBI off of a solo shot would be just what this Chargers team needs. The 1-1 pitch. This is going to be fouled out of play. So we got a 1-2 count for Duffett. Duffett leading the team in batting average this season, a whopping 460. For her. Takes the 1-2, grounds this to Moody. Moody cannot make the play at short. Tough play as she had to, you know, track forward but couldn't cleanly get that one into her glove and make the throw to Brumby at first. That's going to be the second hit now for the Chargers, although actually this is going to go down as an error for North Georgia as Moody was unable to cleanly play that one.
Yeah, that was a tough play, but I think that's a play that the Nighthawks expect Moody to make over there at short. In this type of game, that's going to be a play that she's got to come up with, and hopefully it doesn't come back to bite the Nighthawks and hurt Davis.
That's going to bring Vaught up to bat. As Vaught slams one into left field, and this is going to get down for another base hit for the Chargers, and that's going to put runners in second and third in scoring position now for Alabama Huntsville as they're starting to build up some momentum here in the top of the sixth. One out puts runners in dangerous territory here for North Georgia. And we've seen a couple of times now that the Chargers have had runners on second and third. We saw the bases loaded earlier in this game, and that's going to cause Coach Leah Medina to come out to the circle to talk to Davis.
That makes that error by Moody even more impactful. Now the runner's on second and third with one away instead of having two outs. Even if Vaught gets that hit, it's only going to be a two-out double, which is a lot easier to get one out than two. So hopefully that doesn't come back to hurt the Nighthawks, but not in a good position right now with runners on second and third, only one out.
And you never want to say that, you know, the game comes down to just one play or two plays here, but every play from this point out to the end of this game is going to be big, you know, for both of these squads. Still a tied ball game. No team has been able to crack the scoreboard quite yet. And the Chargers threatening to do so here. As Davis delivers ball one to Henderson, the designated hitter. And Henderson does have one of the two hits for the Chargers this afternoon. The 1-0 pitch. This is going to be in the dirt for ball two from Davis. And the 2-0 makes it ball three. So a 3-0 count now for Henderson. North Georgia trying to avoid loading the bases with one out. Davis needs a strike here. Likes what she sees from Georgia Blair. The 3-0 pitch. Cuts it close for ball four. And here we are in the top of the sixth. Bases are loaded. One out. And Maddie Cartron is going to step back into the batter's box here for Alabama Huntsville as they're looking to take their first lead of this game one and first lead overall for either one of these teams. Big swing there from Cartron. Makes it an 0-1 count. Cartron has struck out and grounded out on her two plate appearances today.
Yeah, and that walk may not be a horrible thing for Davis. Now the Nighthawks can go anywhere in the field, and the infield is playing in, hoping to get the runner at home.
Another big swing there from Cartron, but another miss. Puts Davis up 0-2 in the count. Davis gets the signal. 0-2 pitch. Three straight swings and misses from Cartron is going to give North Georgia the second out here in the top of the sixth. And the seventh strikeout this afternoon from Kristen Davis. And that's now back-to-back games from Kristen Davis where she's posted seven strikeouts. Bailey, she's been phenomenal in this one.
Yeah, she has been. She needs one more out to keep this game scoreless. And now with two outs, the runner or the infield can go back to their normal position, but they still can go anywhere. So if Mixon gets a ball hard to her at third, she can just step on the base. So looking for a ground ball here from Kristen Davis to get out of this inning.
Jessica Eddy is going to try to mount a two-out rally here on the top of the sixth. But Kristen Davis may have other plans. Takes a strike. 1-1 count now for Eddy. Eddy looking for her 18th hit of the season on this at-bat. Takes the 1-1 from Davis. Delivers another strike. Now a 1-2 count. North Georgia trying to get out of this inning. Again, with runners on all the bags, this would be a big out here for Kristen Davis. And the 1-2. This one's going to be low, and runners are going to stay put. Here as Doffitt thought about making a break for it to home, but a good job by Georgia Blair to stay on top of that ball and keep runners on the base.
And that would have been a risky move by Doffitt because that ball did not go very far from Blair, but trying to produce a run any way they can.
Deuce is running wild. 2-2 pitch from Davis. This is going to be popped up, and Ward can't make the play. She drops the ball, and this is going to score two runs for Alabama Huntsville, and North Georgia's able to pick up the out at second. A wild sequence of events there as Alabama Huntsville takes the lead 2-0 as we head to the bottom of the sixth. North Georgia has some work to do when we come back here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
I pledge.
I am an NCAA student athlete.
And I pledge to be a champion of unity
on my team, on my campus, and in my community.
I pledge to embrace differences and strive for inclusion and collaboration.
I pledge to stand against racism, hate, and discrimination.
I pledge to strive for love, care, and forgiveness.
I pledge to stand against silence, deceit, and obscurity.
I pledge to strive for dialogue, truth, and understanding.
I pledge to stand against fear and doubt.
I pledge to strive for trust and belief in one another.
I pledge to stand against complacency and stagnancy.
I pledge to strive for change and growth.
I commit to supporting my fellow student athletes in all circumstances that impact them.
I commit to both choosing unity personally and encouraging it for all.
I pledge these things because we are stronger together,
united as one.
Back with you here on the Nighthawk Sports Network, headed to the bottom of the sixth inning in this matchup between the number two team in the nation, North Georgia, and Alabama Huntsville. And the Chargers take the first lead of the game after a pair of RBIs from Eddie, which sends two runners home for Alabama Huntsville. North Georgia was able to pick up the final out in that one, making the throw to second in time. But a ball that went just outside of the glove of Katie Ward puts two runs up on the board, and the Chargers looking for the upset win here over North Georgia. But these Nighthawk bats may have other plans with the Georgia Blair up to bat. Blair keeps this one in the infield. Throw to first is going to get there on time to Cartron. So with one out, Mallory Parker is going to step back into the batter's box here for North Georgia. And it's been a couple of costly plays here by this North Georgia infield, a couple of unfortunate plays from them. We saw Moody couldn't cleanly make the play earlier in this one as Parker hits a ball to the sky. And this is going to be dropped by the Chargers, makes it an 0-1 count. And then just before that commercial break, we saw that ball go just over the glove of Katie Ward. It was a great effort play by Ward. Had her back to the infield, was trying to make a running, turning play there. But just an unfortunate sequence of events there for North Georgia, Bailey.
Yeah, that would have been a tough play for Katie Ward. She was there, just tipped off her glove, but loved the hustle and effort. Wanted to keep that game scoreless, but couldn't quite corral it with the way it just landed right over her head.
Another foul ball from Mallory Parker is going to make it an 0-2 count. And the 0-2 as Thompson delivers a ball outside, makes it a 1-2 count. Thompson, 6 strikeouts this afternoon, only 2 walked batters and 2 hits allowed from North Georgia, one coming from Ward, other one coming from the pinch hitter, Madison Simmons. Parker's going to take ball 2, evens up the count. Like we mentioned earlier, Parker, what she has going in her favor is that she's never had 3 or 4 straight games without a hit in her collegiate career. Looking for a big one here, fouls this one into right. So we're going to stay at a 2-2 count. Parker's made some nice contact with the ball here on this at-bat. Hasn't been able to keep anything in play, though. But a hit here from the senior out of Kennesaw would be big. Thompson looking at her wrist. 2-2 pitch. Mallory Parker finds her first hit of the afternoon. And the third hit for North Georgia puts a runner on first, and the Nighthawks trying to build back some momentum here in the bottom of the sixth. And we'll see if Grayson Perry can pay things off here for North Georgia with one out, a runner on first, and a home run here would tie this one back up.
And I love that at bat for Mallory Parker. Fouled off a lot of pitchers and fought until she got one. That was a changeup. She just sat back and got enough of it to send up the middle and get a hit.
This one's going to stay in the infield. Throw to first, gets there on time. And that's going to put a runner in scoring position for North Georgia. And Nighthawks are lucky there that the Chargers, unable to convert on a double play, didn't make an attempt at it, but they're one of the best teams in the nation at converting on those double plays. So North Georgia is going to try to mount a two-out rally of their own, something that we've seen them do multiple times this season. We'll see if Mariah Wicker can be the catalyst for that. Takes ball one upstairs. We saw Madison Simmons pinch hit for Mariah Wicker last time she was supposed to be up to bat. Wicker's going to take ball two. And Wicker, she's had a bit of a quiet stretch of games on the road, according to her standards, just three hits across the seven road games prior to today. So she's looking for a bounce-back game here at home where she's made some terrific plays this year. We saw Mallory Parker, you know, break that three-game hitless streak. And Wicker, you know, just like Parker, looking for her to bounce back here.
Yeah, it couldn't come at a better time for Wicker. The Nighthawks need to get something here if they want to have a chance at winning this game. With only being four outs away from a defeat, they're going to need to get things going here quickly.
Wicker, fourth on the team in hits this year, 36 this season. Nine doubles for her as well, four homers, 23 RBIs. She's up 2-0 against Thompson. And the 2-0 to Mariah Wicker is going to be high for ball three. And Thompson has a terrific strikeout-to-walk ratio. She's picked up a couple walks over these past handful of innings, and North Georgia could use another one here, and they get just that. Ball four from Thompson is going to put runners on first and second. Brings Brumby back up to bat. And with the momentum that she's carrying over from this Columbus State series, you'd like to see her get something going here for North Georgia as they try to tie this one up or potentially take their first lead of the game with a Brumby home run. This is going to cause the Chargers to meet inside the circle as they try to talk things over here. Game plan with two outs, and you look at the flip side of things, this would also be a huge out for the Chargers, as North Georgia, this has been probably their best position to score here in this one. So after a quick chat from the infield, Chargers are ready to go. Brumby, before this past weekend, didn't have a single collegiate home run. Now has two this year, including that grand slam. And the first pitch to Brumby is going to be left for a ball. Yeah, Gracie Mixon on deck. So if Brumby's able to extend this inning, either with a hit or a walk, and bring one of the most consistent players on this North Georgia roster, Mixon, up to bat.
Yeah. The Chargers were able to capitalize last half inning with two outs. They were able to rally and get something going. And the Nighthawks are going to have to answer back. It's tough to score with two outs, but it's going to have to be done here if they are going to pull this game out.
And the 2-0... as Thompson delivers one down the middle for strike one. So got Mariah Wicker on first. Still got Mallory Parker on second. After her base hit earlier in this one, the 2-1 pitch. Brumby pops this one up, stays in the infield, and that's going to be caught by the third baseman, number 33, Doffitt, comes over to make the play. North Georgia still not on the scoreboard in this one as we head to the final inning here. Alabama Huntsville up 2-0. We'll step aside for a short commercial break and be back on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Like, what's up, danger? Can't stop me now.
Hollister back to Davis. She throws to first. North Georgia, you are the national champions.
UNG Softball would like to thank one of their sponsors, Kerry Moody Heating and Air, for presenting today's seventh inning. With over 20 years' experience in heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, service, and sales, you can count on Kerry Moody Heating and Air, Inc. for high-quality service at affordable rates. So here we are in the final inning of Game 1 between North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville. Chargers took a 2-0 lead in the top of the sixth. Only runs that have been posted this afternoon have come from Alabama Huntsville. They're going to try to cushion that lead here as this is going to be hit well into left field, but Sydney Blair is there to make the routine play, and those are the kinds of plays that North Georgia needs. Routine plays just like that one to take us to the bottom of the seventh, where they'll have the chance to walk things off. That's going to bring up Caitlin Bryson, the right fielder. She's going to take ball one from Kristen Davis. Bryson rounding out the batting order here for the Chargers. If the Nighthawks are able to get a quick 1-2-3, Davis will have to deal with Hayes, who's on deck, the leadoff batter for Augusta, and then guaranteed to see the plate for North Georgia, barring a pinch hitter from Coach Davenport, is going to be Gracie Mixon, Riley Moody, and Katie Ward. The 1-1 from Davis delivers a ball to Bryson. Counts now 2-1.
It's going to be unfortunate for either pitcher that has to lose this game because they've both pitched fantastic so far this afternoon.
This is going to be popped up into left. Again, another play made by Sydney Blair gives us out number two. And you're absolutely right, Bailey. These two pitchers have been, you know, phenomenal on this one. Chargers were able to find a crack in Davis's game there in the top of the sixth. And, you know, that was just an unfortunate play there by North Georgia's infield as they were able to let up a couple of those runs. Davis delivers strike one to the leadoff batter, Hayes. Hayes still looking for her first hit this afternoon. We saw the Chargers mount that two-out rally in the top of the sixth, trying to do so again here as Hayes knocks her first base hit of the afternoon and keeps this top of the seventh alive for Alabama Huntsville.
That's a great at-bat by Hayes. Puts the ball exactly where you want a slapper to put the ball in. 5-6 all Gracie Mixon, Riley Moody have no chance of that play, and that's a great placement by Hayes.
And like we mentioned earlier, you know, this Alabama Huntsville offense, one of the best that you'll see. Hayes, you know, one of a few players on this team that's batting over 400, batting 424 this season. And like we said, if you moved that batting order into the Peach Bowl Conference, that's top five batting average right there. So it's really a luxury to have three players on your team batting over 400 on the year as they've led this high-powered Chargers offense to 29 wins already this season. Sadie Thompson batting 356 this season. Another high batting average on this Alabama Huntsville squad. Finds herself down 0-2. And the throw to second is going to go into center field. But it doesn't matter. North Georgia picks up the out on the strikeout from Kristen Davis. Her seventh of the afternoon takes us to the bottom of the seventh. We'll see if North Georgia can walk this thing off and come back down from two runs when we come back on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Like, what's up, danger? Can't stop me now.
Hollister back to Davis. She throws to first. North Georgia, you are the national champions.
Well, here we go. Bottom of the seventh. Alabama Huntsville up 2-0 on North Georgia here in game one of our doubleheader on the Nighthawk Sports Network. Nighthawks have a little bit of a hole to climb out of here late. Could potentially walk it off here in this home half of the frame. Gracie Mixon's going to lead things off here for North Georgia. She's going to take a strike from Thompson. Makes it an 0-1 count. Thompson has pitched every inning so far for Alabama Huntsville. Six strikeouts, only walked three batters in this one. Mixon was one of those batters, though, that she walked as Mixon fouls this one behind her. It's going to be an 0-2 count. North Georgia has won six straight games, haven't lost since March 27th. In that first game of their seven-game road series against Lee, Mixon takes the 0-2 pitch and takes a ball from Thompson, a 1-2 count. And Bailey, what North Georgia does have going for them is they have never been shut out this season.
Hopefully you didn't just jinx them there, Robert.
I really hope so. I hope so there. Like, fingers are crossed. It's not often that you see this Nighthawk squad get shut out. We've seen them come away with some close wins, a 1-0 win over Montevallo back on March 19th, a 1-0 win over Flagler.
Yeah, and give all the credit to Josie Thompson so far. Like you mentioned, there have been a few low-scoring games for the Hawks, but we haven't seen this from the Hawks all season, and we'll see if she can get three more outs to get the shutout, but the Hawks looking to get some things going here at the bottom half of the lineup.
It's great to see Mixon leading things off here for North Georgia. Like we said, one of the most consistent players on this North Georgia squad. Takes ball two. Evens the count up. Get the double P signs from the home plate ump. North Georgia looking to break through here late. The 2-2 pitch to Mixon. Mixon grounds this one up the left into left field, and Gracie Mixon records her first hit this afternoon. Puts a runner on first and brings Riley Moody up to bat. And that's exactly what Coach Davenport and North Georgia needed from Mrs. Consistency, Gracie Mixon.
Yeah, that's Gracie Mixon just showing her age and her class. She's a senior, been very reliable, like you said, very consistent, and doing exactly what she needed to there. Bottom of the seventh, you got to get on base, down two runs, and she does just that.
And while her numbers won't necessarily blow you away, she constantly makes the right play and almost never has a cold stretch. She's the only Nighthawk this season to start and play in every game so far for them. Comes up big there, puts a runner on first for Riley Moody. Finds herself down 0-1 against Thompson. A big swing there from Riley Moody. Can't make contact, though. It's an 0-2 count now for the shortstop. Moody shows bunt, pulls it back, takes ball one upstairs. We saw Mixon go down 0-2. Mixon trying to work her way back here. And Moody trying to work her way back just like Mixon. Looking for her first hit today. 1-2 pitch. Takes ball two. Count is even back up. Moody also been super consistent for North Georgia as of recently, like we said earlier. Has had a hit in five straight games. Looking to make it six here. Again, shows bunt, pulls it back. Fouls this one over and into the top row of the stands here at Haynes and Carolyn Hill. So we're going to stay put at a 2-2 count, one out. Got Katie Ward on deck for North Georgia. Big opportunity here for Moody. Another 2-2 pitch. And just like that, the count runs full. Moody has battled her way back into a full count here with Thompson after down 0-2.
That's a good pitch from Thompson. Riley Moody struck out twice. She's chased a lot of rise balls, and that's a good pitch by her. But nice shot by Moody to make adjustments finally in their third at bat.
Payoff pitch. This one's going to be popped up right back into the circle where Thompson will make the play. Gives us our first out here in the bottom of the seventh and brings North Georgia's leadoff batter, Katie Ward, back up to bat. Ward had that hit to lead things off here for North Georgia in the bottom of the first. Hasn't had one since then, was hit by pitch earlier in this game. And she hammers one into right, and that's going to land fair for a base hit for North Georgia. And that's going to put runners on the corners here for North Georgia. And that's going to put a runner in scoring position for the Nighthawks. Still one out. And Georgia Blair is getting ready to come back up to bat. Or Sydney Blair, that is, excuse me. But it looks like Coach Davo is going to put a pinch hitter on for North Georgia. And that's going to be Tegan Laval Masonette, the redshirt freshman from McDonough, Georgia, and Locust Grove High School. Seeing some action here late for North Georgia. It's an interesting move from Coach Davenport, bringing in the redshirt freshman who's posted a .277 batting average this season. And in her plate appearances, she's absolutely made the most of it. This will be her 48th at-bat. She has 13 hits this season, along with 14 RBIs and a home run. So with runners on first and third, one out, the redshirt freshman is going to try to get North Georgia back into this game. Takes ball one from Thompson. And that goes back to what you were saying earlier, Bailey, is not only does this North Georgia team have a lot of seniors on this roster who have been around the block a handful of times, but Coach Davenport has his trust and has faith in players like Tegan Laveo Masonette, who are new to this North Georgia roster. But still, you know, Tegan is, you know, up and down this North Georgia roster, she's one of many Nighthawks on this roster, you know, as good as they come.
Mm-hmm. She's been a very good hitter, got some action when Katie Ward was hurt, and stepped up in a big role, and now she's got an even bigger opportunity here with only one away. Runners scoring position can give the Nighthawks their first run.
She takes ball three upstairs from Thompson, a 3-0 count for Masonette. May not have to do too much on this plate appearance. Seen a couple 4-0 counts from Thompson late in this one. Delivers the 3-0 and right down the middle for strike one. And if you're not going to swing, Thompson is going to make you pay on these rebound pitches here. The deliver strike one. Well, she's walked a handful of batters already in this one. 3-1 pitch as North Georgia is going to have a stolen base here at second. Doesn't matter, though. Doesn't even need it as Thompson walks Tegan, loads the bases, and brings the home run leader and RBI leader, Georgia Blair, up to bat. And Bailey, if you think that if North Georgia's going to climb back into this game and tie this one up, it's going to be with Blair up to bat.
I think that's exactly who you want up. It's the right part of the lineup. Georgia Blair has been struggling today, and this would be a perfect opportunity here for her to get her first hit.
So you got Mixon over there in familiar territory on third, Tegan on first. And over there on second, North Georgia has a pinch runner. That's Madison Cosgrove. So base is loaded, a 1-0 count for Georgia Blair. Takes the pitch from Thompson. Down the middle for strike one. A lot on the line here in this game one matchup. North Georgia looking for their sixth straight win against Alabama Huntsville. And the Chargers looking to go on the road to take down North Georgia for the first time in almost 10 years. April of 2014 was the last time that we saw the Chargers come to Dahlonega to take down the Nighthawks. It's got a 1-2 count for Georgia Blair. Bases loaded. Got Brumby on deck. The 1-2 pitch to Blair as she grounds this one to the short. Throw to first. Or second, excuse me. They're going to say, what's the call here? That she is going to be out at second. But North Georgia is able to score a run to come within one of Alabama Huntsville as Mixon was able to come home.
Now I just got lucky there. Hayes could have potentially made a double play there. Just kind of ran into Masonette to keep Georgia Blair safe. So now I just get one more at bat to see if they can keep this game alive.
Yeah, Mallory Parker is going to try to extend this game for North Georgia. Still got a runner in scoring position in Cosgrove, but she takes a strike from Thompson. This would be huge here from the senior out of Kennesaw, Georgia, if she's able to find her groove again here at home. Had a hit on her last at-bat. Can she get another one here? 0-1 pitch. Fouls this one right back towards the net, and now North Georgia's down to their final strike here in this one. Avoided the shutout, because they did put a run up on the board, but they're looking for the tying run here with Madison Cosgrove over there on third. And the 0-2 pitch to Parker, another foul ball. It's going to keep us at an 0-2 count. Got Grayson Perry on deck. Biggest at-bat of the game for North Georgia. Biggest matchup for Thompson. And the 0-2 pitch to Parker, who fouls another one out of play. This one's going in the direction of Bob Stein Stadium. So we're going to stay right where we are at an 0-2 count. Mallory Parker looking for her 40th hit of the season here. And the 0-2 to Parker. Another foul ball and another one going near the Steiner. Parker battling here with Thompson on this at-bat. And the pressure is on for these two seniors.
It's a great battle between both of them. Mallory Parker, an 0-2 count. Thompson not wanting to back down, has not thrown a ball yet.
And you know Parker is going to keep swinging. Thompson gets the signal. 0-2 pitch. Grounds this one back to Thompson. Thompson makes the flip to first. And that is going to do it here in game number one. as the Chargers come to Dahlonega and for the first time since 2014 steal a game from the number two team in the country as they pick up what's arguably their biggest win of the regular season up to this point, and their third win over a ranked opponent brings them to 30 wins overall as they send North Georgia back to the drawing board with a rematch between these two squads just around the corner. And, you know, that couple of RBIs there at the top of the six for Alabama Huntsville was all that they needed in this one to come away with that 2-1 win. And, you know, had Katie Ward been able to make that play, Bailey, you know, there's no telling how this game could have gone.
Yeah, definitely unfortunate that was the play that won the game for the Chargers, because Kristen Davis pitched a great game, but so did Thompson. They both were fantastic today, and I think that the Chargers were able to capitalize when the Nighthawks weren't able to, and tough loss for the Nighthawks, but I know they're going to rebound in game two.
Well, if you aren't tired of hearing Bailey and I talk, you're in luck, because we'll be back with you in approximately 30 minutes for game two between North Georgia and Alabama Huntsville. Should be in for another fun matchup here on the Nighthawk Sports Network. On behalf of Bailey Vessel and the rest of the NSN team, this is Robert DiClemente saying thanks so much for watching. So long, and we'll see you in